Hi everyone, we hope you are doing well and are safe. I am Dr. Sandhya Patil, practicing in South Bangalore at Daivik ENT Center near to Uttaralli. Today we are going to discuss about the topic allergic rhinitis and its management. The word rhinitis refers to inflammation of the nasal passages, which gives rise to various annoying symptoms like nasal blockage, running nose, sneezing, post-nasal dripping. Few episodes of rhinitis are caused by upper respiratory tract viruses, the most commonly the common cold. The allergic rhinitis is mainly the reaction of the nasal mucosa to the various allergens that are present in the air around you. The allergic rhinitis for most of the people is a lifelong process which waxes and wanes throughout their lifetime. Who gets the allergic rhinitis? Allergic rhinitis is mainly prevalent in 20% of population of all age groups. It starts during childhood and then progresses to the age of up to 30s and 40s. The symptoms that are more common during childhood are like running nose, sneezing, the snoring history, the mouth breathing history which the parents give about the child. And in adulthood, it is more of the running nose, sneezing, post-nasal dripping, itching in the eyes, itching in the throat, itching in the nose. The causes of allergic rhinitis is it's nothing but the nasal reaction to the small airborne particles in the air, which are called as allergens. These allergens initiate an inflammatory reaction in the body, and they cause activation of certain cells like mast cells and basophils, which produce certain chemicals in the body called the histamine, which is responsible for the nasal symptoms like sneezing, running nose, blocked nose, post-nasal dripping. And the allergens which are most commonly responsible for these allergic rhinitis are the pollens from the grass, weeds, molds, fungal molds, and the cockroaches, the animal dander, the fur of the animals. And these allergens, when they initiate certain inflammatory reaction in the lungs, it leads to asthma, and when they initiate reaction in the eyes, they lead to allergic conjunctivitis. There are two types of allergic rhinitis, that is seasonal and perennial. In seasonal allergic rhinitis, the patient has these symptoms during certain seasons of the year, from the month of October, November, December to Feb. And in those are mainly because of the pollens during those seasons which are secreted, and the patients are reacting to those pollens. Whereas in perennial allergic rhinitis, the symptoms are present throughout the year. And the allergens in perennial allergic rhinitis are mainly like dust mites, the furs of the pets, and the fungi that also causes the perennial allergic rhinitis. The common signs and symptoms of allergic rhinitis are concerned to the nose, which causes nasal blockage, running nose, sneezing, itching in the nose, post-nasal dripping, and heaviness in the head. And in the throat, it causes throat irritation and the feeling of something stuck in the throat. And in the ears, you feel the blocked ears. And sleep will be disturbed in such patients. They have disturbed sleep, due to which their activity levels reduces during the daytime. And the diagnosis of allergic rhinitis is mainly by the clinical history, which the doctor takes in detail, the duration of the symptoms, whether it is present throughout the year or during certain seasons. With a proper clinical history, and then certain blood tests are done to know the amount of eosinophils and the immunoglobulin E which is raised in such patients to rule out peripheral eosinophilia. And there is also the skin prick test which we do to detect which type of allergens you are allergic to. Based on that, we can tell the patient to avoid certain measures to avoid exposure to those allergens. And the line of management is the medical line of management and certain environmental measures and immunotherapy. In medical line of management, based on the blood counts and the skin prick test, we tell them to take certain medicines like antihistamines, to control the levels of histamine release in the body. Oral antihistamines and nasal sprays, which are given for a brief period of time based on the response of the patient, we taper it over a period of time. And immunotherapy is also given as an option for the treatment if there is no improvement by the medical line of management. The various environmental measures which are advised to the patient is how to avoid exposure to allergens. At home, they can keep their windows and doors shut during these pollen seasons, and use of air conditioners instead of fan and air coolers, which bring in the pollens. Keep the bed sheets covered by the dust and casings, and wash the bed sheets in hot water instead of warm water, where the fungal molds will be killed in hot water. And if there are pets at home, to keep them out of the house, not let them in the house inside the bedroom, and avoiding exposure to animal dander and their furs. And when planning for outdoor activities, always check for the pollen counts. When the pollen counts are highest in the air, to avoid planning for outdoor activities, especially early morning joggings should be avoided, people who have this allergic history. And foods during the night time should be kept covered so that they don't get exposed to the cockroaches and formation of fungi and all these things. So it is more of a precautionary measures clubbed with the medical line of management, which would bring down the episodes of allergic rhinitis. Yeah, that's it. So I hope this brief discussion about the allergic rhinitis has helped you to get a idea about this allergic rhinitis. So take care, stay safe. Thank you.